Michael O'Byrne and Patricia Bull in for Rob Snow. Patricia, yesterday we saw the Bank of Canada lower interest rates. The major banks followed. And there is some concern that lower interest rates are going to make a red-hot real estate business even hotter out there right now. And there is concern about interest rates and whether or not they should actually raise the amount of a down payment people are allowed to put, increase it a little bit.
Yeah, the Financial Post reporting today that the federal government is taking a look at possibly increasing that minimum down payment. Maybe looking a little harder after what happened yesterday. Mm-hmm. On the line to discuss that with us is Paul Rushforth of Paul Rushforth Real Estate, also the host of Open House, the real estate and mortgage show that comes up on CFRA right here on Saturdays at 10 a.m. It's a long title, Paul.
It is. Thanks for having me on.
Thank you for joining us. So is this something that could happen, that the minimum down payment gets bumped up from 5% to 10%?
No, I don't think so. I know they're looking at it. I think what they're looking at is two different markets. They're looking at the Toronto market and they're looking at the Vancouver market, and they're painting Canada with the same brush. I think that it's a huge mistake. What it will do, it'll take the first-time homebuyers right out of the market, and they're a large percent of our market is trying to get first-time homebuyers in to spur the market to then go into the move-up buyer and then the move-down buyer. So I hope that's not the way they're going to go. I mean, it's encouraging to see that they've lowered the interest rates and get people, start moving in the market. But I mean, Ottawa is a very different situation than Toronto and Vancouver. I mean, Ottawa is a different market, very listing heavy, and it's not hot like Toronto and Vancouver. We're in a buyer's market. We're not in a seller's market. So I definitely hope they don't do that.
Paul, the fact that they are looking at it means that there is some concern out there. What is the concern?
Well, the concern is the amount of consumer debt that people are carrying. And I think they're looking at the wrong debt. I mean, if you look at, we're holding a lot of mortgages because mortgage rates have been, historically low over the last few years. But it's the credit card debt that they need to look at. I mean, Canadians are carrying a large amount of equity in their homes. So if they take a look at the equity rather than just the amount of mortgage that people are carrying or the high volume that people are carrying, I think they'll see that. I don't think we're in a problem here in Canada, and especially in Ottawa. I mean, there's a lot of people who own their houses outright and are carrying a lot of equity in their homes.
Yeah, and when you talk about first-time buyers, it takes, what, typically $300,000 to get into the market in Ottawa on average if you're starting with a townhome. If 5% of that, then you're looking at saving, $15,000. Is my math correct there? $15,000. I mean, it still means that people maybe have to move in with their parents in order to save up enough for down payment. Just achieving that down payment right now is pretty tough. If you start to talk about doubling that, and I know the prices are much higher in some markets, then yeah, it's tough for anyone to think about getting into the market.
It really is. And I mean, in Ottawa, we're lucky. We're insulated, so we're not going up, skyrocketing like Vancouver and Toronto. I mean, the average sale price in Toronto right now is $1 million. And Vancouver, it's even higher. So, going from 5 to 10% in those markets, that's a lot of money you have to put down. So the one thing that's been really good about the Ottawa market and being so insulated is that first-time homebuyers have always been, the driving force behind this market. And I think if they really want to cool the market, then this is going to do it, and it's going to cool the Ottawa market terribly. It's going to cool every market, but I know what they're trying to do. They're trying to cool the Vancouver market, and they're trying to cool the Toronto market. I think the Vancouver market will naturally come that way. The Toronto market, I don't think it's ever going to cool. I mean, there's 40 or 100,000 immigrants coming to Toronto every single year, and only 40,000 housing starts. So they need places to live. I don't think the Toronto market's going to cool anytime soon. But if you start taking the down payment from 5% to 10%, it's going to be tough on a lot of markets, especially the Calgary, the Edmontons, the Ottawas. It's going to be really tough.
Paul, a real estate giant at Royal LePage is quoted as saying that the worry that another rate cut might add fuel to an already red-hot housing market in Canada. Why is that a concern?
Well, I think what happens then, people start over-leveraging themselves. They start getting more house than they can afford because the rates are so low. And then if it ever turns where, the rates start to go up, people are going to be a little bit underwater. We're already seeing it a little bit here in Ottawa. People that have bought their house, a year ago or 2 years ago that are trying to sell, we haven't had much growth over the last 2 years. So a lot of times, if they only put the 5% down, there's not a lot of equity left in that home by the time, you pay a lawyer and you pay a real estate agent. So I think what's happening is this Titan from Royal LePage is basically saying, you know, people are going to start over leveraging themselves even more. And I agree with that? I just think that, you know, maybe the mortgage people and the banks have to be a little more accountable to letting people know what their payments are going to be every single month and whether they can be palatable. But I don't know. I'm pretty optimistic in this market. And I'm pretty optimistic, especially about the Ottawa market, because we haven't seen the dips and the valleys and the peaks. We've just seen a nice, steady market for years, and I think it's going to continue that way.
On that note, and we have to let you go in just a minute here, but what do you think about this sort of recent tendency for the banks not to pass along all the savings that after the central bank makes the rate cut? Took them quite a while last time. They only ended up passing along 15 basis points, pocketing the rest. And so far, it's 10 basis points this time around. Is that frustrating, or do you see where they're coming from, given you know, market conditions?
No, I see where they're coming from. I mean, they still have to protect the consumers out there. Now, they went down 10 basis points. There's a number of banks, I believe Royal has come down 15 basis points, and I think everyone will follow suit. I think everyone will come down those 15 basis points. But, you know, we've come down 50 basis points over the last, you know, 3-4 months, and the banks have come down 30. So they haven't gone exactly what the Bank of Canada is doing, but they still come down, which is good news for consumers and people trying to get into the housing market.
Paul Rushforth is the host of Open House, the Real Estate and Mortgage Show, Saturday mornings from 10 to 11 on CFRA. Paul, thank you very much for this.
My pleasure, guys. Take care.